our meetings, people talk about, and they love to quote these things. Oh, get a PSA if you're this age, or if you're high risk. And another thing they always say, or if you're an African-American male. And then you see these arguments we have all the time. African-Americans have a higher risk from dying of the disease. And is this something going on genetically? People will argue, pathologists, urologists, radiation oncologists, or is it a reflection of a health disparity that their access in general is inadequate? So where do you stand now with all these genetic studies saying, well, there are these genetic variants we're seeing in some African-American men, or these other camps are saying, no, it has nothing to do with that. The more we look at this, it's actually just all straight health disparity that many African-American men and families don't have access to care, so they're diagnosed late. So where do you stand on that, since I've never asked you?
Okay, so I'm gonna give you the short answer and then the detailed answer first, okay?
Okay.
Short answer is garbage in, garbage out, okay? 20 years ago, actually closer to 30 years ago, I was writing papers saying that race was not biologically responsible for differences in outcome between black and white men with prostate cancer. All of these papers were being published saying, oh, prostate cancer is more aggressive in black men. Prostate cancer is more aggressive. And I was going, no, it's not, folks. No, it's not, folks. No, it's not, folks. Mm-hmm. Now, the last time I looked at the data, there were 13, if you just take data from phase 3 prospective randomized trials that have been published, the last time I looked, there were 13 of them that now attempted to adjust for race. And if you adjust for race, 8 of the 13 studies, there was no difference in outcome by race. So now you're talking about randomized, they come in, they get the same workup, they get the same treatment, the same follow-up, race falls out. 3 of them actually showed that African-American men did better than whites. Mm-hmm. And 1 of them showed that whites did better than African-Americans. The ones that showed that African-Americans tend to do better, and there's one actually in press that's gonna be published soon, they were larger and more recent. So all of a sudden, the pendulum is swinging. You know, 30 years ago, everybody would say, the biology is more aggressive in African-American men. The biology is more aggressive in African-American men. And now you got people who are saying, the biology is different in black people and white people, and therefore, you know, black men are doing better. Garbage in, garbage out. Race is not important. What's important is quality of treatment. First of all, you can't do anything about people's race anyway. Race is a phenotypic system that is used to characterize people. Most biologic systems are driven by pressures which occur early in evolution or early in life, and there's not much difference between people. Now, we do know that prostate cancer is more common in African-American men. The area where research needs to be done is not in outcome. If you adjust for everything else, there's nothing different in the biology, but the incidence is clearly more common. And the question is, why is it more common? Well, the most stressed people are African-American men. High unemployment, low education, poor diet, and stress impacts the immune system. So if you take a kidney transplant patient and they get cancer, they're more likely to have aggressive disease. So clearly, stress could explain it, but more work needs to be done. But prostate cancer is not more aggressive in African-American men. It is more common in African-American men. And that explains all or most of the disparity in outcome. Quality of care is a factor, but how common it is a big factor.